While it's cool to create a custom element like this one, it's actually more common to do things like create custom attributes. Now these attributes are going to add things like behaviors. So you set up an attribute using the restrict A for A as attribute, E as element, and then you provide a linking function. And this linking function is going to be where you put whatever the behavior is. So I'm just going to write alert and say I'm working. So from here, instead of having Superman as an element, we'll just do a div with Superman as an attribute. Now if we refresh this, you'll see we get an alert saying I'm working. Now the other places you can put this with this restriction is C is for class. So if I try it right now, you'll see nothing happens. I tried hitting refresh there. That means I just need to say class equals Superman. Hit refresh and I'm working. And then the other one, which I never really see anyone use, but I'll show you anyway, is M for comment. I guess C was already taken for class, so M is for comment. And this looks something like This looks something like you create a regular comment, then you write the word directive, and then you follow it by this. Hit refresh. You can see I'm working. So you could really make it meta if you did it all in comments. Typically, I think it's best to add behaviors and attributes. So you could do Superman and then add another, stack another attribute on top of him. We'll say Flash, and we'll just create another directive and say Flash and attribute. We'll say I'm working faster. I'm working strong. All right, so I'm working faster, I'm working stronger, and then Superman and Flash, hit refresh. See, I'm working stronger and I'm working faster. So there you go. That's more of the idea of what those restrictions are. So again, E is for element, A is attribute, C is for class, M is for comment, but the attributes are going to be the main ones as far as adding behaviors that get used the most.